Hello friends, in this video we will see how to use Spurge VP110 with Eternity NE. Let us see the requirements for the same. Eternity NE VoIP server module available. SIP extensions license. Let us go through the configuration now. Consider a scenario where Eternity NE is configured with static IP address. Spurge VP110 will be registered with the Ethernet port IP address of Eternity NE. Let us move on to the configuration steps. We will complete the configuration in 3 steps. 1. Spurge VP110, that is client configuration, Eternity NE, that is server configuration, directory, that is contact sync. Let us start with the first step of Spurge VP110 configuration. As the first step, connect power adapter or Ethernet cable from a PoE switch to turn on Spurge VP110. Spurge VP110 will be in DHCP mode by default. We can change the network settings from phone's GUI or from the phone. Spurge VP110 can be registered in open SIP mode. We can auto-provision Spurge VP110 with Eternity NE as well. We will use the auto-provisioning feature of Spurge VP110 in this case. This can be done from phone's GUI or phone interface. We will see both the methods. Let us see the auto-provisioning from phone's GUI. Login to the GUI. Go to settings. Followed by auto-provision. Enter the server URL, that is IP address of Ethernet port of Eternity NE. The address will be entered as http://IP address of Ethernet port of Eternity NE:port. Note, the port is Spurge port of Eternity NE. Here, the port is default 80, hence we do not need to put the port. Click confirm. Click auto provision now. This completes the GUI configuration. Let us see how to do the same using phone interface. Enter the menu. Followed by settings. Go to advanced settings. Enter the password. That is 1234 by default. go to Auto Provision. Enter the URL, that is IP address of Ethernet port of Eternity NE. The address will be entered as http://IP address of Ethernet port of Eternity NE:port. Note, the port is Perch port of Eternity NE. Here the port is default, that is 80. Hence, we do not need to put the port. Press save and then OK to auto provision. This completes the configuration of Spurge VP 110. Let us move on to the second step of Eternity NE configuration. Login to Eternity NE as system engineer. Go to basic settings, followed by device management. Registration request from Spurge VP 110 will reflect on this page. Assign the SIP account of Eternity NE to Spurge VP 110. Program SIP ID, that is the extension number to be assigned to Spurge VP 110. Program authentication credentials to be used for authentication. Note, for auto provisioning of third party SIP phones, the phone will be registered on location 1 only. Select the registrar server address. Registrar server address is the address of the SIP server. Eternity NE provides this address to Spurge VP 110 for registration. There are 5 different options available for registrar server address depending on the network architecture. 1. Ethernet IP address. Select this option to register Spurge VP 110 on the Ethernet port IP address of Eternity NE. 2. Mobile port IP address. Select this option when Eternity NE is connected to internet using mobile data of SIM card inserted in Eternity NE. 3. Router or Stunts IP address. Select this option when installation of Eternity NE is behind the router with a static private IP address and the router is having public IP address or dynamic DNS hostname. Note, in this scenario, the following ports must be forwarded to the static private IP address of Eternity NE. Spurge port, SIP port, SIP TLS port if SIP is used over TLS, SIP RTP port range. If router is configured with static public IP address, router's public IP address must be configured under network parameters. If router is configured with dynamic DNS hostname, simple traversal of UDP through NAT, that is TUN, must be configured under network parameters. 4. Dynamic DNS hostname. Select this option when Eternity NE is having dynamic DNS hostname configuration. 5. Automatic. Select this option if you want Eternity NE to assign registrar server address automatically to Spurge VP110. As we are using Spurge VP110 on the Ethernet port IP address of Eternity NE, we will select Use Ethernet IP address in Registrar Server Address field. Go to VoIP port, followed by General Settings for SIP Extension. Select the Source Port IP address. There will be three options available. 1. Use Ethernet Port IP Address. Select this option when Ethernet port of Eternity NE and Spurge VP110 are in the same network. 2. Use IP Address Fetched Using Stun. Select this option when Eternity NE or router is configured with Dynamic DNS account. 3. Use Router's Public IP Address. Select this option when installation of Eternity NE is behind the router and router is configured with Static Public IP Address. We will select Use Ethernet Port IP Address option in this case, as Spurge VP110 is registered on the Ethernet port of Eternity NE. Spurge VP110 will fetch the configuration from Eternity NE and will get registered. This completes the second step of Eternity NE configuration. Let us move on to the third step of directory sync. Go to location settings of Spurge VP110. Select the contacts to be synced in local phone book and remote phone book. The contact selected in local phone book will be synced in local phone book of Spurge VP110, and the contact selected in remote phone book will be synced in remote phone book of Spurge VP110. There are 5 options available for contact sync. 1. Do not send. 2. Select this option if we do not want to override the phone book of Spurge VP110. 3. Send extension numbers only. Select this option to sync the extension numbers of Eternity NE in the Spurge VP110 phone book. 3. Send global directory numbers only. Select this option to sync the numbers configured in global directory of Eternity NE in phone book of Spurge VP110. 4. Send first extension numbers, remaining global directory numbers. Select this option to sync the extension numbers of Eternity NE in Spurge VP110 phone book first, and then send numbers configured in global directory in the remaining capacity. 5. Send first global directory numbers, remaining extension numbers. Select this option to sync the numbers configured in global directory in phone book of Spurge VP110 first, and then send extension numbers of Eternity NE in the remaining capacity. We will select Do Not Send option in local phone book and send first extension numbers remaining global directory numbers in remote phone book. Now we will configure the URL in the phone to fetch the contacts from Eternity NE. Login to phone's GUI. Go to directory, followed by remote phone book. The URL for remote phone book will be autofilled. If the URL is not autofilled, enter the URL in the following manner: http://ip/remote_phonebook_yealink.xml. The phone will download the contacts from Eternity NE. With this, we finish the entire configuration. Thank you for watching this video. For further queries and support, contact Matrix Technical Support Team. For more videos, go to our YouTube channel, Matrix ComSec.